Hi guys, welcome and welcome back to Beyond Infinity Tarot channel. So today's topic is a very special topic because your spirit guide has important message for you. Okay, so I hope you are doing well and I hope this reading brings some light and clarity to your situation in life in general. So let's start with your reading. So before we start with your reading, you have three paths to choose from. Okay, you have three paths to choose from. Pile one is going to be no. Okay. And pile two is going to be assertive, and pile three is going to be reconsider. Okay, don't get discouraged by the no card. Okay, so let's start with your reading. So select your option and let's start with your reading. Hi pile one, so you chose no card. This is going to be your reading. So first message from your spirit guide is don't get discouraged by the things that are not working out. And I just heard, don't get disheartened because of your situation, because the fog that is in front of your face and your head is clearing up. So be patient, okay? Not everything is lost yet. That's what your spirit guide wants you to know for the opening message, okay? So let's see. What important message pile one spirit guide wants to tell pile one? Okay, so back of the deck you have the Empress card here. The Star card. Okay, so for signs I'm picking up on a Pisces, Aquarius, Libra, Leo, Sagittarius, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, Sagittarius, yes. Aquarius, I said it, Gemini as well. Okay, so what your spirit guide wants you to know, yes, the fog is clearing up in front of your eyes because there is something that you can't see yet. Okay, so you have to keep working, you have to keep patience, and you have to keep working because I heard, like, have faith, okay, that everything is going to work out for you. Okay, so there is something that you can't see yet. Okay, it's going to, okay, there is something, I feel like this is like a situation that is going to play out in your life that is actually going to help you to get started something new. Okay, this is the thing that you are not seeing yet. Okay, so you have to keep faith because there is some sort of confusion that is going on in your life right now with the Seven of Cups here and Justice is here. So this confusion is about to clear up so you can see this new way in your life. Okay, in your situation. Okay, with the Eight of Pentacles and Wheel of Fortune, it's going to be unexpected, and with the Moon card and the Star card and the Justice. So I feel like you are feeling it from the inside, that within your heart, that it is working out, like something is going to change. Okay, or something is about to bring out some clarity or some light to your situation, and you have this kind of a feeling that everything is going to be all right. Okay, so your spirit guides want you to know that keep this feeling in your heart because it is going to work out. Okay, and with this Star and Justice, I feel like your spirit guides want you to know that don't play small, okay, and raise your standards. Okay, in relationships or in any relationships or anything, okay, raise your standards. Like, maintain the standards that you have, okay? Don't lower it for someone else because you are not someone who is you are very rare person, okay, pile one, that your spirit guides want you to know. You are very unique, you are very rare, you are very beautiful, you are very gorgeous, you are very handsome, okay? Take what resonates. So there are some people who may try to play out a role where they may try to create that illusion that you are lower than that, or you shouldn't have those standards that you have or that you carry because they can't reach your standards. Okay, so they are just playing they are just reversing the roles because they want to have something that you have. Okay, yes, that's kind of illusion that they create with the Seven of Pentacles here. And Seven of Cups, okay, and we have Nine of Pentacles here and the Knight of Swords. So don't play small, okay? That's what your spirit guides want you to know. With the Empress card here, you have to step into the power of your feminine energy, okay? No matter what gender you are watching this reading right now, it applies to everyone, okay? It means that you have to get in touch with your emotions, okay? Because of some hurtful situation in the past and because of some things or some people, they didn't give you the respect and the things that you truly deserve in any relationship or any situation or in life in general. Don't try to close off emotionally. Okay, you have to be in touch with your emotions, okay? So you can feel that you can feel that you are worthy of everything that you're deserving of, okay? That's what your spirit guides want you to know here. With the Nine of Pentacles here and the Knight of Swords, you are a very independent individual. You love your freedom. You don't like to being asked what to do. Like someone watching this reading right now is not liking what I'm saying because they are like, why you are telling me what to do? Okay, I'm not going to listen. Okay, it's fine. Okay, if you don't want to listen, it's not me saying this. It's your spirit guides want you to know this. Okay, so Nine of Pentacles here and the Knight of Swords is tells about. You don't like your freedom to take away from, okay? And with the Knight of Swords, this big change is about to happen in your life and you have to stand in your power, okay? You have to call back your power. You have to call back your power from these illusions, from people, places and situation that is not serving you anymore, so that you can face this Knight of Swords energy with ease, okay? Because you have all it takes to face this challenge, okay? That is a challenge or change that is about to enter your life, okay? I'm not saying challenge because it is something that is going to ask something new from you, okay? It is going to ask you to be your authentic self. It is going to ask something that you have to think out of the box. It is something that is going to ask you to be in your feminine energy or get in tune with your emotions, okay? So this is something that is going to happen, okay? With the Eight of Pentacles energy and the Wheel of Fortune, okay? If you have been working towards something, some project, or you are waiting for some sort of a financial gain and you are not seeing the results that you deserve, then it's going to change for you, okay? The big sum of money or there is something, okay, related to the financial gain is entering in your life, okay? Or maybe you are going to invest in something that is going to give you unexpected blessings and the financial gains, okay? That's what I'm seeing here, okay? Pay attention to your dreams, okay? And your spirit just wants you to know that fix your sleeping schedule, okay? And also, don't lower your standards, okay? You are a very beautiful person, okay, pile one. Okay, and maybe there is someone that you are invested into, okay, so much, okay? Maybe you don't talk to this person anymore, or yes, I'm seeing a person here, not a situation, okay? So take what resonates with you, okay? This person is not giving you what you are giving to that person, on you you have already left the situation or that person behind, okay? But still in your heart, you kind of have some good feelings or some, okay, you have some feelings for this person, okay? So whatever, they're good or bad, okay, whatever that is. But your spirit guide wants you to know that you shouldn't go back to things that make you feel like you are small, okay? Or who doesn't respect your worth, okay? Respect you, or who doesn't know your worth, okay? That's what your spirit guide wants you to know. And everything, whoever is kind of trying to play dirty here with you or for you, behind your back or in front of your eyes, they are going to receive what they are doing, okay? So you don't have to worry about that. That's what your spirit guides want you to know. So I hope this message resonated, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Love and peace. Hi, pile two. You chose be assertive. This is going to be a reading. So first message, your spirit guides want you to know that if you have hope regarding to a situation or person that is going to get better, okay, and you have done the work on from your part, then sit back and relax. Because it's going to happen if it is good for you, okay? It is something that is for your highest good. That is going to make you shine like this, not shy, okay? What your spirit, pile two spirit guides, want you to know. Important message from your spirit guides. Okay, this card wants to go first here, so yeah. Clarify the High Priestess. Your spirit guides don't talk too much, and your spirit guides are very protective over you, Pazio. Okay, if you ever feel that way, okay, and you are kind of a person who, okay, you know what I feel from this cards for you. Your spirit guides are so protective over you. If they sense that someone or something has not a good genuine intention towards you, they don't come around. Okay, they don't even approach you, because your spirit guides don't want that kind of negativity in your life. Okay. Yeah, even if you still are facing some sort of a negativity or some things, because you are learning some lessons, or this is something for so that you can move on from that energies, okay? If you are feeling that way, okay? Why the Five of Swords is here? Five of Wands is here. Ten of Cups. Clarify the Page of Swords. Okay. So there is some sort of jealousy going around, okay? With the Queen of Pentacles and the Queen of Swords energy, okay? Okay, let's start with your reading. So with the Five of Wands here, let's start with this. And Page of Pentacles, clarified with the Page of Pentacles. So your spirit guide is saying that if you are waiting for some sort of call, okay, about a certain job offer, or you are about to get some project, or if you are about to, you know, it's kind of like you are into the competition, and there are a lot of competitors around you for that same goal or same thing that you want. And if that is something that is truly for your good, okay, if that is something that is truly you are deserving of, I mean in a good way, you will get it. Okay, that's what your spirit guides want you to know. If you are stressing over something like that, okay, because you have the potential to grow in that particular field, or in that particular so you can make it come true. Okay, it is in the either it's here, like you are thinking about doing it, or it's something that you have in your mind, or you are waiting for a call, okay, or you have already applied somewhere, okay, or you are already into the competition, or you are thinking about doing it. If you think that it is going to bring out, you are in a planning stage right now, that is, it's going to bring out something good for you, okay, and you are so committed for that, then go for it. It's going to happen, okay, and it is good time to learn something about that particular field or particular thing that you are interested in, because you will get some ideas or some ways so you can get what you want. That's what your spirit guides want you to know here. And with the High Priestess here, and yeah, one more message your spirit guides want you to know, that it's okay to shine, okay? It's okay to be different, it's okay to have a different opinions, if it's okay to think different from others, okay? There's nothing wrong with that, and always try to maintain that uniqueness that you carry, okay? That's what your spirit guides want you to know, because it's going to help you get what you want in life. And with the High Priestess clarified with the King of Wands energy. You have the Ten of Cups, the Queen of Swords energy here, and the Wheel of Fortune. The Page of Sword energy, Three of Cups, and Five of Pentacles. I'm getting a lot of different messages, okay, here. So with the High Priestess, you are a very intuitive person, okay, pile two. And for the signs, I'm getting Earth signs, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Pisces, Virgo, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, Leo, Sagittarius, like most of all of the signs, okay? Yeah. So with the high priestess energy, two types of messages I'm getting. Either your spirit guide is telling you that you are a very intuitive person, but you are very energetic, you are very visionary, okay? You are also good at planning things. You have the good visions, and also it's like you have the balance of both. I'm sensing here, okay? So it's okay, so keep up with that. Okay, so don't forget to be connected with your intuition. That's what your spirit guides want you to know. It's okay to have dreams and goals and something apart from your spiritual aspects. Okay, that's what your spirit guides want you to know. And with a Ten of Cups here and the Queen of Swords and Wheel of Fortune energy here, I feel like pile one, you have had, okay, a connection or relationship, or you, it's like a person I'm picking up on here, and you thought that it is the one, okay? They are the one, okay? And but they have it, I'm sensing here third party energy for some reason, okay? So, and you thought it is going to be the Ten of Cups energy, that it's going to be like a wish fulfillment for you, but it turns out that this person has someone else, okay? This person, okay, the connection has a third party, okay? This person has a third party and you don't like it, so you withdrawn yourself from that situation with the Wheel of Fortune energy. It was unexpected for this person, so that this person thought that you are not going to find out this whole situation, but you did, okay? And you tried to move away from this energy and from this person and connection in general. This is the right thing that you have done. That's what your spirit guides want you to know. And with the Page of Sword energy, Three of Cups and Five of Pentacles here, that whoever that third party was is still jealous of you, because this person, the King of Wands energy here, is still kind of comparing you and this third party, okay? And this person, I don't know what kind of person is this, but this person is kind of giving you some sort of a priority over this third party, okay? And this third party doesn't like it, and so they are kind of jealous of you. Or I'm sensing this person, okay, whoever that past person was, is also have some sort of a better feelings towards you, okay? The Page of Swords, the petty feelings, okay? And they are kind of like talking about you because they are struggling in life, okay? They are struggling without you, okay? That's what your spirit guides want you to know. Yeah, this is like a very specific message for someone, so take what resonates with you. And with the Queen of Pentacles energy and the Ten of Cups here and the Wheel of Fortune, okay? It's okay if some things or some connection doesn't work out because it was not meant to be. Because what you are aiming for with the Ten of Cups and Wheel of Fortune is far better and far bigger than what you currently think that you're deserving of, okay? So keep working on that, because you never know how things will change for you in a good way. Okay, that's what I have for you, Pile 2. I hope messages resonated, and I'll see you next time. Bye, love and peace. Hi, Pile 3. So you just reconsider. This is going to be your reading. So first thing I felt with this card, reconsider, I feel like some of you are opening up their third eye chakra and some sort of a healing ability. Okay, so take what resonates with you. But I feel like there is some sort of a deep knowledge that you are awakening to, okay? That's what I heard, okay, for you. And what your spirit guides want you to know here, you have the ability to turn everything into gold, okay? If you touch something, okay, metaphorically, okay, that's what I'm saying here. And so you have to be very careful with where you put your energy into and what option do you choose. I feel like you are going through a period of time where you have to decide something, or where you have to start something new, or there is some sort of a planning, okay, that you are currently going through, okay? So planning stage, or you have to decide something. So you have to like take your time and be very mindful, okay, what option and what, like, what option do you choose and what process do you choose. to proceed with what you have already decided to do. Okay, that's what your spirit guides want you to know. Important message for you. Yes, that is very important. These are these two cards going to come out. Okay, the World card, the Four of Sword energy, then Three of Pentacles. Okay. All right. Okay, so it's going to be okay. Let's see what I was feeling here. Yeah, we have the Temperance, okay? So, I understand what is this all about. Okay, so you may have a Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, Sagittarius in your chart, Virgo, as I said already, in the Cups energy, so Pisces. But most strongly, I'm see picking up on Earth signs here, okay? I feel like you are feeling the sense of that you don't belong here, or there is like you have some sort of a dissatisfaction with your life, okay, pile 3, and you feel like you are not resonating with your environment or with the world, or what kind of you know, for example, if there is some sort of a trend that is going on and everything is in love with that trend, and but you don't feel like it, okay, to participate into that trend, or you don't even like that trend. Okay, that's kind of energy I'm picking up on from you. Okay, and why you are feeling it, I told you, you are opening up to some higher truth. Okay, you are actually leveling up, okay, spiritually, emotionally, mentally, physically. So this is kind of a normal, that's what your spirit guides want you to know, because whatever that progress, that growth, the internal growth that you are going through right now is going to bring out something best for you. Okay, that's what I'm getting. So I feel like you are spending money on things, maybe to try to distract yourself, maybe you're shopping, you're doing something, okay, so you don't feel this kind of frustration or emptiness or dissatisfaction, but it's not working, so you are very confused, like what to do next. Okay, that's kind of vibe I'm getting from you. So you have to be very, you have both cards here, Wheel of Fortune and the Temperance here. So you have this, you have to take it slow. You have to be very patient with yourself, okay? Before you make any decision, don't try to rush into anything. Find the middle ground, okay? That's what I heard from your spirit guides. Okay, and you have the Five of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles. So 4-4. So you are definitely feeling some sort of insecurity. Either it can be a material insecurity or insecurity in general. Okay, insecurity in terms of the things that you used to feel secure with. Okay, that's what I'm picking up on here. So maybe you are doing well in your career, in life, in your monetary aspects in general, but there is something that internally you are not feeling, that you are associating with your environment, or yeah, that's the energy I'm getting here. So your spirit guides want you to know that it's normal. You are awakening to some deeper truth, okay, about your life and about things around you, okay? And with the Hermit card here, you might like to spend some time in nature, and you are going to be stepping away from this Nine of Sword energy and stepping into in this Hermit energy. Okay, you are going to finally understand why things are happening in certain way and why certain things doesn't work out when you, okay, and you have another 9 here, so 999. So definitely you are ending something heavy right now, okay? You are dealing with some heavy energy. So if you feel like, okay, pile 3, you can't take some decision, okay, don't try to rush into making decisions, because it may go wrong, it may cause you some trouble financially. But if you take your time while making this decision, it's going to bring you some new opportunities. I'm not saying that it's going to get bad or something like that, but you have to take your time, okay, before you are starting something new or before you make any decision, okay? Just don't make any decision based on how you are feeling currently, impulsively with your emotions, okay? Or in a pressure of some situation or some person or someone or some group, okay? If you don't feel like you should do some things, don't do it, okay? So take your time, sit with yourself and ask if this is something that you want. And if you ask your help from your angels and from your spirit guides, they are going to likely help you. You are being guided right now, so you don't have to worry about this. But this is the thing that your spirit guides want you to know, that you can take these things into consideration so you won't feel this horrible energy anymore. Okay? And with the King of Pentacles here and the Devil card here, I'm just getting two types of messages here, so take what resonates with you. Not everything can be resolved with money, okay? There are some situations or some issues can be solved without money involved in this, okay? So that's what your spirit guides want you to know. So I don't know who this message is for, okay? And don't be too materialistic, so try to escape from this internal conflict, or it's not the solution, okay? That's what your spirit guides want you to know. So don't try to indulge in some things or things that are not good for you, or that are kind of addicting or addictions or anything that is actually distracting you from where you should be, okay? That's the energy. That's what your spirit guides want you to know. Because it soon is going to end, okay? It's 999. Okay, so this situation is about to end soon. So, and you will kind of understand why some things just didn't work out, and why certain things resolved with the money. And money, it was not the issue, okay? Money was not the issue. Even if you have too much money, or if you are struggling with money, okay, money was not the issue of your life, okay? There is something else that is going to come to light, okay? And you will be very glad to know the truth, okay, of the situation and why certain things happen in certain way, okay? Your spirit guides want you to know, just because you were so patient and just because you did so much internal progress, you are going to be awarded with the new opportunities, new beginning and abundance in all areas of your life. Okay, so that's what I have for you, Part 3. I hope messages resonated, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Love and peace.